Taking Control with Dr. Josh.
Another school shooting, this time in New Mexico, involving a 12-year-old boy. And over in Florida, a man is dead after being shot inside a movie theater, reportedly because he was texting. So how do we explain all of this to our children? Joining us this morning is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Klapo to help explain all this. You know, for kids, this really hits home. One case, it's a 12-year-old. The other case, texting, and all kids text. So how do you help explain this to children?
It's really, really hard. And, you know, we unfortunately have been sitting here before talking about this topic. But what I do think is unique about this one is not so much that it's graphic. I mean, obviously it's graphic. But the topics really hit home with kids when you're talking about texting and you're talking about a fellow student who's 12 years old shooting. So we have to be careful as we move through the next several weeks to help our kids. And the most important thing, and this is one that's really difficult, you know, we always talk about sort of shielding them from the media and filtering information. In this case, it's not so much because you're going to see graphic images, it's because you're going to hear conversations about texting and shooting. You're going to hear conversations about a 12-year-old bringing a gun in a backpack. And so as parents, we're going to be faced with some really difficult questions from our kids.
And you do say there is a way to handle this and so that the kids can handle it as well. And you say there are certain steps parents can take, and one of them is to limit exposure to TV?
Right. Your kids are going to watch TV. But as you know, lots of information is coming through. You've got to be there with your kids, particularly if they're, you know, if they're watching the news with you, if they're reading things on the internet. You've got to be there to help address their concerns. And that's really the second one. Trying to explain this whole thing to your kids is impossible because we don't understand it ourselves. So instead, what I want you to do is listen. Listen to what their concerns are and address their concerns versus trying to kind of wrap this thing up in a bow and explain it, because you can't. And related to that, remember that kids do really well with actions. So the conversations that you're having with them should be action-oriented. So, you know, take, for example, the movie theater shooting. Talk about texting and not texting in the movie theater. Not to scare them, not to talk about being shot, but to talk to them about why it's rude. To talk to them about if somebody tells you to put your phone away, you put your phone away. So those kinds of conversations. If you go over to the shooting in the school, talk about lockdown drills. Talk about it being okay if they hear something that someone says to go to an adult. So again, you see, it's a conversation, but it's very action-oriented.
And I think I always try to, even with my two-year-old, assure them that I will do everything I can to keep them safe. And you say that's real important.
It is very important. It's not the only thing you have to do, because again, this is a world that is unsafe, unfortunately. So you do need to convey that to them. And then the last thing, and this is one that's going to be even tougher for us as adults, this is a politically charged discussion, and we're hearing it everywhere. It's great to have political debates. Do not have them in front of your kids, and I'll tell you why. As you get emotionally charged, all that your kids understand from that is the stress and the anxiety. So have the debates, but be a parent in front of your kids.
Great advice, Dr. Josh, as always. Thank you.
Thanks, Gina.
All right, Mark?